Well, good evening, everyone. I love that music. I hope it got your heart racing a little bit. You know, I look out at you and I think we must be sitting ringside at a gold medal game because it's going to feel a little bit like that tonight, so don't worry. If you're having a little bit of issue because you're not allowed to watch the Olympics tonight, this is just as much fun. And you'll be cheering for your own loved ones. So welcome, welcome. It's so nice to see you all here today. This is a very special event, and most importantly, this is a day for students to walk across our stage and become graduates of BCIT. But this is also a day for all of you, family, friends, to join us to celebrate these accomplishments. Now, my name is Julia Foy. I'm a faculty member in the Broadcast and Online Journalism Program at BCIT, and I will be your Master of Ceremonies this evening. Now, I would first like to acknowledge that we're on the traditional territory of the Coast Salish people, which includes the Squamish, Musqueam, and Tsleil-Waututh nations. Now, I'd also like to acknowledge our interpreters joining us on stage today, Darcy and Antonia. Now, a little bit of housekeeping before we start. We do have a professional photographer here with us today from Mountain West Studios. Now, professional photos will be taken of each graduate immediately after they cross the stage. They'll have the opportunity to view and purchase the photo at order.mountainwest.ca by entering the code BCIT2018. Now, we encourage you to take any personal photos of your graduate following the ceremony. Now, the photographers will also be available for individual portraits and with family members after the ceremony. Follow the signs up the stairs to room 3040. There's a $15 cash-only sit fee for the service. Now, in addition to all that, we're doing a live stream video of this ceremony right now at bcit.ca. So if somebody couldn't make it here tonight, tell them to jump online and they can join us. This means there's no reason for you to capture your own video of the ceremony. Don't come and rush the stage. The link to the professional video will remain on our website for several months. You can view it again and again or download it to keep it for yourself. Now, we want to make this an enjoyable occasion for everyone. So once you've texted, tweeted, or talked, please ensure that anything you have that makes noise is turned to silent during the ceremony. Now, our participants are just about to enter the auditorium. Our Piper Vern Kennedy will lead our faculty and platform party. Now, once they're on place, it will be time to welcome our students. They'll be led by Jennifer Figner, Chair Education Council, and Donna Mackay, Registrar. So please rise to greet our processions and remain standing until after the singing of the national anthem. Our processions begin with our faculty and our platform party.
Thank you.
about a round of applause for our platform party? And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the class of 2018. I told you it was going to feel like a gold medal game, and it sure does. Welcome in the house. Now please remain standing and join in the singing of our national anthem, led by Stephanie Standerwick. Thank you very much, Stephanie. Would everyone please be seated? I'd now like to ask Joanne Stone Campbell to come forward to bring a welcome from the Coast Salish people. Now, Joanne is the coordinator for BCIT's Indigenous Services and a member of the Squamish Nation.
Good evening. BCIT has always been a special place that has supported unique paths of learning. No student is the same. No educational journey is the same. I'm very proud to work here and watch our Indigenous students learn and grow and teach. My name is Joanne Stone Campbell. I carry two names. My first name I carry is a Yemowit from Squamish Nation, which means blanket of strength. And I also carry a spirit name, which is Sound of Thunderbird speaking from the Anishinaabe Nation. I've been here at BCIT for the past 17 years and enjoy every day watching students graduate from here. Last year, our country marked 150 years of Confederation, but the Coast Salish people know that the legacy of the land goes back much further, much further. So today, on this day of Convocation, I ask that you take a moment to think about Canada's next 150 years and what you can do as leaders to help our communities to move forward. Let's all make a renewed pledge to reconciliation in our hearts and within our families, in our homes, our workplaces, and classrooms. On behalf of the Coast Salish people, which includes the Squamish, Musqueam, Tsleil-Waututh, I welcome BCIT community, graduates, family, and friends to our traditional territories. Congratulations on this incredible achievement. Waichkat.
Thank you very, very much, Joanne. I'd now like to welcome the Aboriginal women's ensemble, Ma Girl, who'll be performing a traditional song of welcome and celebration.
Congratulations to all of you. This is a song, a Cree song from Cheryl Rondell and Joseph Natauhau. And you might know it when we do the English translation. Hey,
yeah.
Thank you very much. Those drums, you just feel it in your heart. They're so wonderful. I would now like to introduce our platform party. I'll ask them to stand when I call their names and to please remain standing. Please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. Starting with the back row, Donna Mackay, Registrar. Tim David, VP External Affairs, Student Association. Anne Syme, Associate Dean, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Cheryl Isaac, Associate Dean, Specialty Nursing. Craig Larson, Associate Dean, Diagnostic and Advanced Practice. Patricia Sackville, Associate Dean, Academic Studies. Bethany Edmonds, Associate Dean, Computing. Joanne Stone Campbell, Coordinator, Indigenous Services. Moving now to the front row, we have Jennifer Figner, Chair, Education Council. James Rout, Associate Vice President, Education Support and Innovation. Tom Romer, Vice President, Academic. Jack Davidson, Chair, BCIT Board of Governors. Our keynote speaker tonight, Dr. Alan Eaves, President and CEO, Stem Cell Technologies Incorporated. Kathy Kinlock, our President. Steve Eccles, Dean, School of Computing and Academic Studies. Sharman Lee, Dean, School of Health Sciences. Kim Dotto, Dean, Applied Research and Technology Center. Lawrence Gu, Dean, BCIT International. Ladies and gentlemen, your platform party. I now call upon President Kathy Kinlock for her opening remarks.
Thank you, Julia. Welcome, everyone. I'm so excited to be with you tonight to share in this special milestone, your convocation ceremony. Graduates of BCIT, you've earned an impressive credential and the right to be excited about your future. But before any of you cross the stage, let's acknowledge some other very impressive people in the room. Thank you, first of all, to the friends and family of our graduates. You have supported our grads in countless ways. It's largely because of you that they are here today. So thank you so much. Thank you also to our faculty and staff, those who are here and those who have spent many hours with our students. Your generosity is inspiring. You've worked hard to get our students here. And I know how proud you are of them and how special this is for you to see them cross the stage as well. Thank you for being inclusive, for striving to make the benefit of BCIT education accessible for all of our students. And I personally defy any other post-secondary to produce a more dedicated group of faculty. Let's give them a round of applause. So I'm going to ask the graduates to please stand now and thank the people in the room who've supported you. Give them a big shout out. Just give them, have it stand and give them a big round of applause. Great. I hear yelling mom and dad somewhere. Please be seated, it's great. So graduates, I now turn to you. Thank you. Thank you for putting your faith in us. Thank you for supporting one another and for your perseverance. I hear BCIT is not particularly the easiest road. We demand a lot, yet we promise a lot. We promise grads, you, who are adept in their field, yet humble in their character. Workers who are collaborative in spirit and entrepreneurial in approach. Citizens who strive for personal success and success in the world. Innovative thinkers who will solve some of the greatest issues of our times. With this group of you, I believe we've delivered on that ambitious promise. Graduates, this is a day of celebration, a moment to reflect proudly on all of your accomplishments and those of your fellow graduates. I wish I had the time to say a few words about each of you, but I know you want to go out and celebrate. So I won't do that. Instead, I'll just recognize a couple of exceptional people as examples for our guests. First, I'd like to recognize Jyoti George Lee, graduating tonight in computer systems technology. Could you stand, Jha, if you're here? Can you stand? Okay, I can't see. George has had the highest GPA in a second-year specialization option, technical programming, and a very strong GPA overall in an extremely challenging program. He was a team leader for the final group project, and I'm told he put a significant effort into guiding and teaching other students. And computing isn't even his first love. He has a strong academic background, coming to BCIT Computing after studying business and obtaining significant international experience. So his instructors tell me that he's an excellent team player who's highly respected by his classmates alike and faculty alike. That's an example of the contribution and the challenge and the type of profile we have for students. I'd also like to recognize Shamim Chowdhury, who's here tonight. Shamim, are you? I'm not battering too well here. Oh, good, good, you're right at the front. Thank you, I can see you. I'd like to recognize Shamim Chowdhury, and tonight his mother is here representing him. Graduating today with his diploma in technology and nuclear medicine. And unfortunately, Shamim is unable to be here today, but he's joining us online, so he's watching right now. And later, when it's time for our graduates to cross the stage, his mom will collect his diploma on his behalf, and we're so pleased that you're here to do that. For those of you who have known Shamim, this won't be surprising because he wouldn't want to miss a thing. In fact, although he struggled to overcome severe medical issues, Shamim managed to keep attending classes. Shamim even returned to complete his clinical practicum and the rest of his final exams after he had to undergo a liver transplant during the final exam week. He successfully wrote and passed his national certification exam just last month. Shamim, your instructors tell me you never complained about the challenges and you never gave up hope that you would graduate. Your determination and your resilience are an inspiration to all of us, and I want you to know that as your BCIT family, we're all rooting for your quick recovery. Let's give him a round of applause and support. Pretty remarkable. Generosity, determination, flexibility. These are important traits, traits demonstrated at one time or another by all of you as graduates. And I can see that you'll take those into the future. Now I'd like to introduce one more special graduate to you now. Katrina Hijack, would you stand, please? Katrina. There you go. Now she doesn't know I'm going to call on her either, so I'd like to ask all of our graduates to return to their seat after receiving their credential and to be present to celebrate Katrina's moment as she celebrates yours. Now you're probably asking me why. Because she will be the last person to cross the stage tonight, and she deserves a raucous cheer. So as a thank you for letting me do this, Katrina, and for us embarrassing you grandly, I'd like to give you a certificate for a dinner that you can go out and celebrate afterwards. So graduates, your adventure's just beginning. The road does not end here, and neither should your education, whether it's back at BCIT, through additional education, or in new roles in industry, please keep learning. Read, travel, learn, talk to strangers, and most of all, stay curious. Have fun, you've earned it. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Kathy. I'd now like to call upon Jack Davidson, who will bring greetings from the board and introduce our keynote speaker.
Students, grads, you know you're grads. I know it took some real work on your part to get here today. Congratulations. Look at that, I started on the wrong page. I'm going to start again here. Usually I have somebody that flips pages for me, but do it myself. Good evening, everyone. I'm delighted to be here today and congratulate our grads and to commend our faculty and staff for doing a great job. And on behalf of the BCIT Board of Governors, welcome. I'd like to take a moment to recognize a few governors that are here tonight. Jennifer Figner, Scott McAlpine in the middle here, Sergey Bukharov, did I see him? Yeah, there he is. And I think that's it. Yep. And now I'm back to where I started. Students and grads, I know it took some real work to get here. Congratulations. When you made the choice to come to BCIT, you changed the course of your future. Employers know that when they hire a BCIT grad, they're getting someone who can hit the ground running. BCIT grads are known for their drive, their talent, and their ability to work hard and get the job done. You are confident in just what industry needs today. Remember that. You're job ready and you're good at it. Whatever path you embark on, I know you will make a difference. You have earned the confidence of your instructors. They know just what it took for you to get here today. Each of you should feel very proud, as we are very proud of you. For most of you, your time at BCIT has come to an end. But your achievements won't stop here. BCIT grads are the ones who make good things happen all across the province, all across our country. If there's building or expansion or anything going on, there's always BCIT grads involved. BCIT is critical to BC's economy, economic prosperity, and now you are all part of making the future happen. Remember to give back. Commit yourself to making an impact, to making life better within your future workplace, within your community, within our great province. Now, to close this little talk, I want you to think about this. I'm a BCIT grad. I graduated in 1969. Don't bother doing the math. I'm an old guy. And I'm part of the generation that's running things today. And here's the secret. We don't make change because we see the light. Us old guys, we make change because we feel the heat. And it's your turn to apply that heat, to get the change that's needed for the next generation that's following after you. One caution, be gentle. Soon enough, you will be the old guys. So, on behalf of the BCIT Board of Governors, our warmest congratulations to you and all of your academic and personal achievements. Good luck as you move forward. Thank you. This evening, I'm also very privileged to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Ellen Eves, President and CEO of Stem Cell Technologies. Dr. Eves was the founding director of the Terry Fox Laboratory for Cancer Research for 25 years and head of clinical hematology at the University of British Columbia for 18 years. Since 1993, he has devoted himself to building Stem Cell Technologies Incorporated, a company he founded that provides standardized tissue culture for regeneration, for regenerative medical and those doing research. Stem Cell is now Canada's largest biotech company with over 1,000 employees and a global network of sales offices and distribution centers serving thousands of customers. He is passionate about providing excellent tools for researchers and creating rewarding employment for those who love science, which makes him an excellent keynote for our gathering today. Please help me welcoming Dr. Alan Eaves.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here, and Jack took most of my speech away, and I wanted to say all sorts of good things about you, but he's already done it. So, but I want to say that we hire a lot of people from BCIT, and they're all wonderful. They've helped make our company into the success it is. But we're a little different company than what you might normally see. We're scientists helping scientists, and that's our tagline. And science, as you know, is all about discovering the truth about things. So we're all about truth and honesty. So I say this to and meet with all the new employees and say, you know, we just want to do things right. We want to be totally honest, and we want to just be so careful about what we do, because we are making the tools that are going to help people cure cancer and other diseases. So just remember, it's all about the quality of our products. There's not a lot of IP or intellectual property. It's really the quality of our products that are about what make us successful. And I have to say that BCIT students fit into our culture amazingly well. They see themselves not only as scientists helping scientists, but also colleagues helping colleagues. They help each other to make our products the very best that there are in the world. And the result of that is that our sales are 96% of our products are outside of Canada. So we are servicing the world. So I just wanted to sort of congratulate you on your contributions to Stem Cell Technologies, and to say that I've been asked to come and tell you a little bit about why I started a company that employs so many BCIT grads. Initially, it was all about making money to support our research in the Terry Fox Lab, because there's never enough money for doing research, cancer research in particular. But more recently, as Jack mentioned, I've become very passionate about hiring young people who really love science, but can't get jobs in science in Canada and end up going to the United States. We want to keep them here in Canada with great jobs, and that's what the major role, I think, of Stem Cell Technologies now is. To help support our research in the Terry Fox Lab initially, though, the lab was produced, we needed erythropoietin. Now, erythropoietin is the one of the early hormones that was discovered related to the blood-forming system. And we knew that it was in the urine of people. And we developed a way, we wanted to use it for growing red cell progenitors, which we're studying, we are and still do study the regulation of growth and differentiation of blood-forming stem cells and how they differentiate into red cells, white cells, and platelets, and why they go wrong in leukemia and other cancers of the blood. So we were trying to get do these things. We needed this hormone erythropoietin. It was very expensive. And so we decided to collect urine from patients who are very anemic and purify this erythropoietin ourselves, which we did. And so this has been, this we made several million dollars by selling this to our colleagues around the world. But the point is that I make is it was very simple to do this, very technical, and exactly the sort of things that we drew on people with your skills to help us do. And I have to say that, of course, urine is probably still one of the most untouched natural resources of Canada that still needs to be exploited fully. So The problem occurred in 1985, though. Amgen, which is the first large biotech company in the world, they also got a lot of urine, made a lot of erythropoietin, got the protein sequence, and then the genomic sequence, and then produced it in bulk. And we feared, of course, that our little market of selling this to our colleagues around the world would disappear. So we started adding it to our media and selling our whole media, which was for growing red cell and granulocyte progenitors in culture. And of course, this erythropoietin that we produced gave beautiful red cell colonies. So my first marketing foray was to call this ready mix. So it was red, and it was sort of this goo that was sort of like ready mix cement. And so I advertised in the journal Blood, and suddenly sales shot up. And over the next several years, this media became the gold standard for the world in people who wanted to measure blood-forming stem cells anywhere, and allowed them to compare their results from one lab to the next. Now, the BC Cancer Agency, the board of directors thought, this is a great idea. It could grow even more. So they said, Alan, why don't you buy this business from us? The money will go to support the Terry Fox Lab, and you can grow this business and make it into something much bigger. I actually didn't think it was going to be all that successful, but they were right and I was wrong. But I was a little nervous of getting investors, so I mortgaged my house in Vancouver, which I bought for $90,000. So it was a few years ago. And I got a loan from Western Economic Diversification, and we used that money to build a clean room and set up a company that we called Stem Cell Technologies. So with 10 staff and sales growing nicely, I basically realized that I didn't know very much about business. So I started to read about business books and did numerous business plans to see how I would grow this thing. And I just want to tell you that if you get into the entrepreneurial spirit and you want to make things happen, there are two books that you need to read. One is called The 1 Minute Manager, which is about a 2-hour read, which tells you how to manage people. And the other book is called The E-Myth, which tells you how to set up a small company and make it profitable. So I read those books, but I read about a whole bunch of other books, and I sort of did a sort of do-it-yourself MBA to try to bring myself up to speed, because I was still working in the Terry Fox Lab and in the Division of Hematology. So this was just an aside thing, this little company that I was starting. I didn't really realize that how important it was going to be. So I also found out that we only had one product, right? And we needed additional products to really give it sustainability. So I licensed in a way of separating cells, different cell populations, by using antibodies to put little particles of iron on specific proteins on the surface of various cell populations, and then putting them under magnet, you pull away like lymphocytes from all the other cells. And a way for, if you want a pure population of lymphocytes for doing AIDS diagnosis and so on, you use our media, or our cell separation technique. So, and the other thing, I licensed in media that was specifically designed for growing human progenitor cells of all types. So we initially focused, of course, on research use only products to avoid all the issues of regulatory problems, like getting approval by the FDA and all that. So we were just selling directly to scientists, and they loved our products, and they still love our products. So, but those products are now becoming so good that our medias are in about 20 different clinical trials, and we're moving to make our medias in a GMP facility so they can be used approved by the FDA and used for patient treatment. So 25 years later, Stem Cell is now a global leader in providing research reagents and instruments for the new cellular therapies of gene therapy, regenerative medicine, and tissue engineering. At present, we have over 1,000 employees, a global sales network, and distribution centers in Vancouver, Seattle, Grenoble, France, Singapore, and Beijing. So we're definitely a global company. In Vancouver and Burnaby, we have 850 employees in four buildings where we do all our research and our manufacturing, sales, and marketing. But we're going to consolidate all this in Burnaby, where I have just leased for 40 years a 200,000 square foot warehouse on Production Way, in which we're going to build and create our new stem cell campus. So we're going to continue to grow because we anticipate sales will continue at about 15 to 20% per year. And then if that's the case, we will need to hire basically 3,000 more people over the next 12 years. So we're looking forward to help from you and other graduates and graduates yet to come at BCIT to help us do this. Also, to help us and similar companies, we all want to see BCIT expanding its excellent training programs to be more like MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where there's going to be a huge spectrum of people in terms of instrumentation, computer science, and so on, right up to the PhD level. We need to have people trained in this way in close association with industry to really move the economy forward. So I'm making a pitch that we need to really grow this institution. It's done wonderful things. We want to bring it up to a higher level. And so in conclusion, I want to say that healthcare, in all its complexity, is now the biggest industry in the world, with huge opportunities for further growth. No one wants to die, you may have noticed that, and people everywhere have more money to spend on their health. In Canada, how do we turn our healthcare system from a huge cost center into a revenue generator? Hopefully this will happen by building more companies like Stem Cell, where 95% of our sales come from outside the country, and those export dollars coming into the country are worth 2 to 3 times more than dollars generated within an economy. It's those export dollars that are so important. And of course, having products that the rest of the world loves and we made here, but they're also used here, how do we expand that to support all of our healthcare system? I occasionally say that we should certainly be the world's leader in incontinence pads, because there's plastic, which comes from oil, and there's fiber, which comes from wood. So, you know, we need to grow all our, that's a joke, no one's laughing. So we should definitely be a leader in incontinent pads, but we should be leaders in all sorts of other areas. Okay, so I just want to make a plug for being an entrepreneur and thinking about how to make all these things happen. So a low stem cell was started by exploiting a natural resource called urine. Canada now needs to turn from a resource-based economy to a knowledge-based economy focused on the huge global healthcare industry. So in conclusion, I really want to make a couple of take-home messages that you might be interested in hearing. So I want to say, being truthful to yourself and others is essential for your success. Science and the knowledge-based economy are the future. Your education never ends, so keep reading books, taking courses, and thinking. Health is huge. Let's turn it into a revenue generator for Canada. We want and need BCIT to become the MIT of Canada. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Alan. Thank you for sharing your success story and inspiring us all. And I never knew that urine could be so valuable, but I'm looking forward to that. Oh, and by the way, I owe an apology to Jack, because I'm the MC, so I'm probably the official page turner. So I apologize. Hopefully he'll ask me back again. Now we come to that exciting moment when our graduates are about to cross the stage and be recognized for completing their programs here at BCIT. Now here's the process we're going to be following. The students will leave the auditorium up the aisle. They're going to return through the side door on my left. Now they're going to hand me their credential, I'll read their name, and then I'll return their credential. Then our grads are going to come over and shake a few hands as they cross the stage. They'll meet Kathy Kinlock, Jack Davidson, and Dr. Alan Eaves, and the dean of their school. Now, you may also notice a few of the faculty members coming forward to join the line and shake the hands of the students that they've instructed and supported over their time here. And this is a really special connection between our students and faculty, and it's an important part of the BCIT experience. Now, as each graduate leaves the stage, they'll become a BCIT alumnus or alumna, and a member of the BCIT Alumni Association, joining a global membership of over 175,000 alumni. Now, you'll be presented with an alumni pin to mark this occasion. We hope that you'll wear your pins proudly and keep in touch with BCIT. Now, graduates are then going to exit the theater via stage right and be directed to a special area where our professional photographers will be taking a photo of them with their credentials. Now, graduates will then be directed back to their seats. Now, as Kathy mentioned in her remarks earlier, we want to be sure that all of our graduates, from the very first to the very last, cross the stage to our final graduate are equally and respectfully acknowledged as they receive their credentials. So we ask graduates to please return to your seat and, along with all of our guests, continue to be present and recognize your fellow graduates in their important moment. Now, would our platform party please take your places to congratulate our graduates? Oh, look who's starting to arrive here. I always like to say I'm a broadcaster, not a linguist. I'm going to do my best, but I'm going to get to meet every single one of our grads. All right, here we go. School of Computing and Academic Studies, Dean Steve Eccles, Bachelor of Technology, Computer Systems. Rob Cavello. That's for you. Hello. How are you? Stephen Chow. Congratulations. Kyle Michael Giles? Gills. Kyle Michael Gills with distinction, which means he's kept an 80% average. Well done. All right, Manuel Eduardo Gonzalez Ara, with distinction. Congrats.
Hello. Thank you so much. Alexandra Nicole Kabak.
Alexandra Nicole Kabak, with distinction.
Thank you. Hello. Thank you so much. Ning Ma.
Ning Ma, with distinction. Manbir is a little busy with the phone here, but Manbir Singh Nat with distinction.
Are we doing Ray Abraham Varkey?
Ray Abraham Varkey.
Thank you. Hello. Now, Jackie
Yee. Bachelor of Technology, Forensic Investigation, Computer Crime Option. This is Christopher James Grant.
Maria Hossein.
Maria Hossein. Marina Hossein. Thank you.
Hello, William Wendell Laycraft.
William Wendell Laycraft. Thank you, sir. Sarah Emily McNary, with distinction.
Thank you. Hello. Thank you, sir.
Bachelor of Technology, Forensic Investigation, Crime and Intelligence Analysis Option. One more time here. Gaurav Katari.
Hello.
Sanaya Vij.
Thank you, thank
Joseph Bagatin. Excellent. Bachelor of Technology, Forensic Investigation, Forensic Science option, Mike Joseph Bagatin. Gagajot Kandel with distinction. Prabjot Singh. Computer Information Technology, Kwang Bing Vu. Computer Systems Client Server option, Hanuk Choi. Thank you.
Hello.
Kevin Decoy. Computer Systems Database option, Kevin Decoy. Hi, how are we doing here? Nelson Gu. Yeah. Nelson Gu with distinction.
Hello.
Jeffrey Nguyen.
Thank you, sir.
Taryn Ray. Taryn Ray with distinction. Lennox Jung. Computer Systems Digital Processing option, Zach Koop.
Oops, one little card. We'll get that guy. No worries. Andrew Busto.
Excellent. Computer Systems Technical Programming option, Andrew Busto, with distinction. Sei Kwang Chung.
Thank you. So Connor Jesse Orion Moody.
Gowdy. Connor Jesse Orion Gowdy with distinction.
Lancelet Heradura.
Lancelet Heradura. Smile to the audience. Dongwon Kim with distinction. They're getting very shy. They're turning their backs to you.
Hello, Van Throng Lam.
Excellent. Smile for the folks. Van Throng Lam.
There we go. Hello. How are we doing? Paul McCarley.
Paul McCarley with distinction. Computer Systems, Web and Mobile option, Nico Arellano, with distinction.
Hello. Morris Arroyo, Arroyo.
Ah, Morris Arroyo, with distinction. Bryn Adrian Bodery with distinction.
There it is. Thank you, sir. Clinton James Bach.
Clinton James Bach with distinction.
Thank you, sir. Daniel Capaccio.
Daniel Capaccio with distinction.
There you are, sir.
Stephen Chang with distinction.
Thank you so much, Jim Cole.
Jim Cole.
Hello. Hansel.
Hansel Lee with distinction.
Very nice. Oh, thank you, sir. Better help me with that.
Yudhvir Raj with distinction. Jasmeet Singh Sekhon. There you are, sir. Thank you very much.
Tin Yung Gabriel Yip.
Tin Yung Gabriel Yip with distinction.
Very nice. Hello, sir. Lang Zhao.
Lang Zhao with distinction.
Hello, hello. So we have a new side, Sergey Bukharov.
Okay. Computer systems cloud computing option. Sergey Bukharov with distinction.
Chun Lin Chen.
Chun Lin Chen.
Are we doing Kenneth Kulala? Kulala.
Kenneth Kulala with distinction. Tim Davis with distinction.
Excellent. Hello. Jonathan Hagen.
Jonathan Hagen with distinction.
There we go. Hello. Spencer Leslie.
Spencer Leslie with distinction.
Very nice.
Penji Liang with distinction.
Very nice. Hi. And it's Yannick.
Yannick Wien.
Hello. Okay.
Harshita Sharma. Harshita Sharma with distinction. Kieran Stickney with distinction.
Thank you. Hello.
Yu Heng Song with distinction.
Thank you, sir. Hello.
Yunan Tang.
Thank you.
Certificate, Network Administration and Security Professional, Muhammad Nadim Khan, with distinction.
Thank you. Excellent.
I'll do my best. BCIT Industry Partnership Certificate, Office Administrator with Technology, Ami Aspurata. Yay! Jipinder Jitkar Thin. Thank you.
Jan or Jan? Jan Myron Lyle Gabriel.
BCIT Industry Partnership Certificate, Technology Support Professional, Jan Myron Lyle Gabriel.
Hello. How are we doing? Caro Oliveira? Icaro? Oliveira?
Certificate, Computer Systems, Icaro Oliveira, with distinction. That's for you. Thank you, sir. Excellent. Advanced Certificate, Forensic Investigation, Crime and Intelligence Analysis Option, Vanessa Gonzalez, with distinction. Wentz Jung.
Thank you. Excellent.
Advanced Certificate Forensic Investigation, Forensic Health Sciences Option, Lily Christ with distinction.
Thank you. Two parts, my goodness, and Mary Grace Dela Cruz Moniz.
School of Health Sciences, Dean Sharman Lee, Diploma Cardiology Technology. Mary Grace Dela Cruz Moniz. Is. Diploma Diagnostic Medical Sonography, Erica Beyer with distinction. June Sow. June Sow with distinction. Tiffany Ann Childs with distinction. Robin Ashley Drayson with distinction.
Very nice. Hello. I don't know if that was all the ladies here. Allison Marjorie Robillard Gurney?
Oh, let's give it a go. Allison Marjorie Robillard Gurney with distinction. Courtney Barbara May Hoitsema with distinction.
Thank you. Excellent.
Elizabeth Dawn Mayo with distinction.
Very nice.
Christopher Peter Fujio Miki with distinction.
There you are.
Rochelle Lynn Northcott with distinction.
Very nice.
Abby Ray Parahudoff with distinction. Therese Poulin with distinction. Chanel Samuel with distinction.
Hello.
Madeline Rose Schultz with distinction. Christine Viney with distinction. Katrina Walton with distinction.
Hello.
Oh,
Fiona
Tanya Weens. Fion. Ooh. Fion Tanya Weens with distinction.
There we go.
Hello.
Diploma Medical Radiography, Chantel Anderson with distinction. Chelsea Bajwa with distinction.
Hello. Jessica Bourdignon.
Jessica Bourdignon with distinction.
Hello.
Kaylin Bronswick.
Kaylin Bronswick.
Thank you.
Carrie Chen with distinction.
Hi. All right, Emily. Excellent.
Emily Dame with distinction.
Thank you. How are you doing, Natasha Diaz
with distinction. Mallory Dino with distinction.
Nice. Adam Gates.
Adam Gates with distinction.
Hello. Now Alana Goring. Excellent.
Alana Goring with distinction. Morgan Healy.
Nice work.
Hello.
Megan Hill.
Nice job.
Catherine Hoy, with distinction. Amit Veer Claire, with distinction.
Nice. Hello.
Jessica Cynthia Klink, with distinction. Brittany Nicole Cron, with distinction.
Mariah Cron, you twins?
Oh, look, the twin sisters here too. Mariah Cron, with distinction.
Jessica
Kwan. Okay. Jessica Kwan.
Yay.
Charmaine Lee.
Thank you.
Leora Lee, with distinction.
Hi. Edmund Lee.
Edmund Lee, with distinction. Jordan McInnes, with distinction.
Hello. How are we doing? Cham Maldo?
Cham Maldo, with distinction.
Alicia Mayer, excellent.
Alicia Mayer, with distinction. Krista Meek, with distinction. Nicole Morrison.
Congrats. Abby Lynn Monroe.
Abby Lynn Monroe, with distinction. Ashley Narang, with distinction.
There you are.
Erica Marie Nickdow.
Hello. And we have Samantha O'Brien.
Samantha O'Brien, with distinction.
Very nice.
Darren Bradley Oak, with distinction.
Now, Jed?
Jed Orpilla, with distinction.
There you are.
Brittany Sarah O'Quinn, with distinction. Selena Pham.
Hi. Corinne Ellen Ratke.
Corinne Ellen Ratke.
Congrats. Hello. How are we doing, Paulina Ross? So easy.
Paulini Rosemarek, with distinction.
Thank you.
Rayanne Alyssa Shelbourne, with distinction.
There you are. Thanks so much, Shayla Snow.
Meet Shayla Snow, with distinction.
Thank you. Excellent. Denise Spacek?
Denise Spacek, with distinction. Matthew Tong, with distinction.
Hello.
Maggie Tung, with distinction. Jennifer Marie Tai, with distinction.
Hello. Now, Haley Elizabeth Zimmerman.
Haley Elizabeth Zimmerman, with distinction. Diploma Nuclear Medicine, Natasha Aga, with distinction.
Hello, hello. How are we doing? Lauren Faulkner.
Lauren Faulkner, with distinction.
Hello. Andre Ho.
Andre Ho, with distinction. Crystal Nazareth, with distinction.
Very nice. Hello, hello. Brandon Pagnuco.
Brandon Pagnuco.
There you are, sir. Hello.
Mackenzie Ricard, with distinction. Kayla Wagner, with distinction.
Now you remember Kathy introducing us to Tamina Shroudry on behalf of Shamim Shroudry. He's accepting his Diploma of Technology in Nuclear Medicine today. Thank you for being here.
Bachelor of Technology, Environmental Health, Jacqueline Chu, with distinction.
Thank you.
Pooja Kumar, with distinction.
Hello.
Jill Chang Sheng Lin, with distinction.
There you go.
Melissa Xu, with distinction. Jonathan Ryan Wong, with distinction. Advanced Diploma, Clinical Genetics, Rachel Martins, with distinction.
Hello. Jean-Therese
Pomerang, with distinction. Very nice. Certificate, Occupational Health and Safety, this is Karina Abe, with distinction.
Hello. And John McDaniel.
John McDaniel. Very nice.
Hello. Thanks, Dan Phillips.
Meet Dan Phillips, with distinction.
Thank you.
Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Lorenzo Amanguera, with distinction. It's about having fun.
Yay. Let's try Sadie Au.
Sadie Au, with distinction. Abigail Oxalon, with distinction.
Hello, hello. Jennifer Boston.
Jennifer Bosnick with distinction.
Hello, hello.
Surya Carmichael with distinction. Braden Carter with distinction. There you are, sir.
And it's
Connie Hong Yin Chan with distinction. Amanda Chu with distinction. Jennifer Call with distinction. Enjoy.
Hello. Kathleen Christina Dealey.
Kathleen Christina Dealey. Thank you very much.
Hello. Hi, Catherine Rachel De Peralta.
Catherine Rachel De Peralta with distinction. Sancha Devetta with distinction. You're going to remember her. Kayla Pauline DeBauda with distinction. Emily. Charlotte Emily Dubois with distinction.
You're going to want that.
You're going to want that.
All right, let's see Derek Albana.
Derek Albana with distinction. There you are, sir.
All right, Lori Ann Ellis.
Laura Ann Ellis with distinction.
All right, Dylan Alexander Earhart.
Earhart. Dylan Alexandra Earhart with distinction. Mary Page Field with distinction. Serena Gee with distinction.
Thank you.
Angela Giacomazza with distinction. Kashtan Giannubilo with distinction. Diane Grubick with distinction.
There we go. All right, Tony Hurston.
Tony Hurston with distinction. Alexandra Hakova with distinction. Haley Hurst with distinction. Sienna Joyce with distinction.
There it is.
Kia Cavusi with distinction. Marianne Cocurio with distinction. Julia Kubik with distinction. Kaylee Lamb.
Very nice.
Farina Lau with distinction.
Pretty.
Anna Lee, with distinction.
Hi.
Jennifer Lee, with distinction.
Nice.
Polly Lee, with distinction. Peggy Lynn, with distinction. Sarah McKay, with distinction. Nikki Mahindru, with distinction. Deandra Mark, with distinction.
There you are.
Amrit Moore, with distinction.
Thank you.
Marie Elise Murray, with distinction. Celia Carr Palmer Borowski, with distinction. Jamie Park, with distinction.
Nice.
Andrew Patterson, with distinction. Marie Abigail Payumo, with distinction. Alana Jane Pearson, with distinction. James Michael Pedgrashi, with distinction.
You're welcome.
Keisha Player, with distinction.
Yes. Hello. How are we doing? Svetlana.
Svetlana Plotnikova, with distinction. Yasemin Rafapour, with distinction.
Congrats. Natalie Rice, excellent.
Natalie Rice, with distinction. Arina Satchik, with distinction. Vanya Skekic, with distinction.
There we go.
Ashley Alexandria Shum, with distinction.
Nice.
Parveen Kaur Sidhu, with distinction. Simi Sidhu, with distinction.
And you'll want one of those. There's the crowd. All right, Millicent Stewart.
Millicent Stewart, with distinction.
Hi.
Cynthia Tan, with distinction.
Very nice.
Sasha Teller Sawyer, with distinction.
There you are. Thank you very much. Kimberly Tolentino.
Kimberly Tolentino, with distinction.
So, Lauren, excellent.
Lauren Topham, with distinction.
Very nice.
Miramaya Varensavu, with distinction. Alexandra Catherine Wallace, with distinction.
There you are.
Excellent. Brandon Weaver, with distinction. Emily May Dawn Weaver, with distinction. Gary Wong, with distinction. Jennifer Paris Wong, with distinction.
Jamie Ashley Yen,
with distinction. Laura Young, with distinction.
Very nice.
Nicole Yoon, with distinction. Amanda Marie Zayance, with distinction.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Specialty Nursing, Emergency Nursing Specialty, Krisha Dodds, with distinction. Perinatal Nursing Specialty, Sheila Taylor, with distinction. Tracy Thiessen, with distinction. Oksana Toropova, with distinction. Perioperative Nursing Specialty, Charlene Dawn Wiley, with distinction.
Oh my goodness. We all admire your strength, Raven.
Give this man a hand. He came up on crutches here tonight. Holy cow. Advanced Certificate, Occupational Health Nursing Specialty, Raman Bike, with distinction.
There you are, sir.
Be careful. Christine Chen, with distinction. Very nice. Advanced Certificate Perinatal Nursing Specialty, Don Luis Castillo, with distinction. Look who's here, it's Katrina! Katrina! Katrina Heidich, with distinction. Wow. Now, as you know, there's a few students that we've just given a bit of applause. They're going to run off. They're going to get their photos done. So I'm going to do a little bit of housekeeping for a few moments. As our students return from their professional photos backstage, I'll remind you that those photos will be available for purchase in about a week from Mountain West. Now, instructions to access them are on our graduation website. And of course, hopefully you'll remember that you can go to our BCIT website and download tonight's ceremony so you can watch it again and again and again. And you can send it to people overseas. And I'm now thinking, all right, is everyone back in their chairs? I don't know. There's probably a few people taking photographs. And the reason that I'm tap dancing is only because we're about to do something really cool, and they're going to be mad at us if they're not back in their chair. So we'll give them a couple of moments. We are going to do something with all of the grads. And I think, you know what, while we're waiting, why don't we give a round of applause to the class of 2018? Now, I had to laugh because you think the Olympics are an international event. I would say this is an international event, and it was almost as exciting as a gold medal game. Really, it's been a lot of fun tonight. All right, so now it's my honor to introduce Jennifer Figner. She's the chair of Education Council. Would you please come forward for this special moment?
Absolutely. Thanks, Julia. Probably a lot of you haven't heard of Education Council and spent even less time thinking about what Education Council means in terms of your education. So here's what we do. Throughout the year, it's the role of Education Council to advise BCIT's Board of Governors on a variety of educational policies, priorities, and programs. We review any new programs that are going to be launched, major changes to existing programs, and we set the criteria for awards that some of you have received, academic standing, and those exams that you all love dearly. So through this, we're involved in many aspects of the programs that you've completed in order to earn the certificates, diplomas, and degrees here today. Now this evening, as chair of Education Council, I get to do the fun part. So graduates, can I ask that you all please stand? And flip the tassels to the left-hand side of your caps, signifying you're now officially a graduate of BCIT. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2018.
Thank you very much, Jennifer. Please be seated. I'd now like to call Kayla DeBauda, a Bachelor of Science nursing graduate, to come forward and deliver the valedictorian address.
Welcome, honored guests, platform party, faculty, family, friends, and my fellow grads. Thank you all for being here tonight. I'm honored to be addressing this year's graduating class and to be representing such a diverse and accomplished group of individuals from the School of Computing and Academic Studies, as well as the School of Health Sciences. Although we may all come from different programs within BCIT, tonight we are united as BCIT alumni. I am proud to call myself a BCIT graduate and to be standing alongside each and every one of you tonight. I'm so excited to see what we will all accomplish in the years to come. Each of us had our own unique experiences at BCIT. It was a combination of good times, and not so great times, times of laughter, and lots of times of last minute studying. Graduation marks the end of an extraordinary chapter in our lives. It seems like just yesterday we were walking onto campus for the very first time, bags overloaded with new books and a readiness to attend our first day of orientation. I still remember my program head telling us that on the first day of school, To truly learn, we need to push ourselves outside of our normal comfort zones. Well, BCIT has truly taught us to find comfort in the uncomfortable situations that life throws our way. We were taught to embrace every day as a new opportunity to learn something and as a chance to grow. Today, we receive our degrees and diplomas, signifying not only our effort and dedication, but also the support and the strength of all those who have helped us along the way. For all the loved ones here tonight supporting and motivating us, both academically and emotionally, you have been instrumental in our success. You are our driving force, the wind in our sails. We will forever be indebted to you for your time, support, motivation, and love. A quote from Marianne Williamson has always resonated with me, so I'll share it with you. Remember this for the times in life where fear or self-doubt stands in your way. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? I thought of Marianne Williamson during my second year of nursing, shortly after starting my new role with the BCIT Student Association as Chair of Health Sciences. Between all the homework, the meetings, the emails, and the rest of life, I started to doubt myself. I was afraid I wasn't going to be able to keep everything balanced. I remember my first big, major public speaking endeavor in this role. I was so nervous I could hardly speak, my cheeks turning bright red as I joined the conversation with the team. The topic of discussion was simply our objectives. As I began to explain my objectives, I also began to doubt my ability to fulfill these goals and was fearful that these endeavors wouldn't make a meaningful difference to student life. Looking back, I realized that my fears and doubts were acting as a barrier to everything I wanted to accomplish. I'm certain each and every person who crossed this stage tonight can share a similar story. We all have the capacity to accomplish great things. Surely we have proven that through our ability to persevere through the BCIT program. Don't ever underestimate your power to be successful and your ability to make the world a better place. When you leave here tonight, celebrate your accomplishments, but also look forward to see how you too can inspire others. Now please welcome me in congratulating the 2018 BCIT graduates.
Please be seated. Isn't she wonderful, Kayla? Wow. So Kayla, now it's time for you to celebrate with your graduates, and together you can all inspire and be proud and be powerful as you go forward. I just want to acknowledge the fact that of Kayla's involvement in so many things at BCIT over the years, in addition to studying. It's no small feat, and that's really something. Kayla has, just let me review this for you because she's too modest to tell you. In the time you enrolled here, you've been an advocate for BCIT students and BCIT as a whole, and in fact, she's demonstrated a unique focus towards establishing initiatives that will leave a legacy of health and wellness for BCIT students. One of your nominators wrote, "Kayla's commitment to health and wellness on campus cannot be understated. She's one of the strongest advocates and leaders, not only within our organization, but on campus and on the community." Elected by your fellow students as a Student Association Chair of the School of Health Sciences, Kayla, you quickly became a strong advocate for a new campus wellness center, inspiring the creation of a student wellness ambassador team and you were instrumental in founding a BCIT chapter of JAC.org, a national peer-to-peer wellness support group, a system that is very collaborative, it's cool. In collaboration with the Interprofessional Student Committee and in the Health School of Health Sciences, you also, just in case you've retired, organized a hugely successful Power Hour events, bringing in leading speakers to discuss a wide variety of topics on healthcare. These events drew in hundreds of students and community members, and it was great to attend a few. Before I let you go, though, I want to share a comment from one of your nominators. Kayla's innovative ideas and abilities to get so many projects started demonstrates a genuine caring and commitment to the BCIT organization, as well as leaving a legacy for future students. She's an exceptional student leader, and I'm confident that she will succeed in whatever endeavor she pursues. Kayla, it's been a pleasure to have you as a leader at BCIT. I know you're going to go far. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Kayla and Kathy. Congratulations. Well, guess what? Now it's time to celebrate with our graduates. But before we do, just a couple of reminders. Leader Frames is available just outside in the hall if you'd like to have that fancy credential professionally framed today. Goldfish Photo Booth is also in the foyer for instant photos and social media sharing. Mountain West Studios will be available for studio portraits of graduates, located upstairs in room 3040. And I also want to remind you about that video of the ceremony. You can go to bcit.ca/convocation, and you'll be directed from there. Now, everyone's invited to go for refreshments following the ceremony. The reception will be held in the gymnasium, which is just across from the auditorium. Now, graduates, please return to the gowning area to remove your gowns before going to the reception. And please move away from the doors as you leave to avoid congestion. Sometimes we get a lot of hugs and kisses happening right there. Thank you to all of the volunteers and staff for their efforts tonight. And lastly, a note to those who just crossed the stage. It was so exciting meeting every single one of you. Now, you've just completed a chapter of your journey, and congratulations. We hope that BCIT continues to be part of your future as you grow and develop in your chosen field, and I wish you the very best. Thank you very, very much for joining us tonight. Our processions will now leave the auditorium, first the platform party, followed by our faculty, and then our graduates. I ask everyone now to stand and remain standing until our graduates have departed. Thank you, and have a wonderful evening.